Always a dog barking when you're just about to start filming. For the last few weeks I've been working on the camper van and also been away in the camper van too, taking some time out and seeing some family and things like that, so it's been a good little break away. Time to get the shed now. This build's going to be a clock, a very large clock, about 600 millimeters in diameter. So it's not going to be a very complex build, it'll be a fairly fast build. I'm going to be using my new roller, which I just recently completed, and there's a YouTube video for that. And using some reclaimed wood, some simple joinery and stuff like that. So hope you enjoy the video, sit back and enjoy. I might use that, I might use a bit of this, whatever that is. So I've got a bit of everything in here: Australian hardwood, silky oak, American walnut, Oregon, more silky oak, hardwood. This is maple, Queensland maple. So is that. And this is Queensland silver ash. Decided against using these pieces of silver ash. They could probably be better used as propellers for an aeroplane. Way too much. So just need to fill in this little bit there. Alright, next day, let the glue dry overnight. Come out nice and flat, might just have to run some 120 grit over it for just a little bit and see how that looks. So next I'm gonna put in some of this wood butter. It's a wax and tung oil mix. Just checking the Z heights are all the same because it's a bit wonky. It's rustic wood and we've got to get it all fairly even for the CNC. So that was all my fault. I didn't set my zero position to the machine bed. I made it to the material surface and now I'm going to have to cut out hatch in here to make it look good again. Gosh. Ready to try again. Take two. I'm really liking this lettering, but I did stop the CNC when it comes to the Forme Industrious. It just goes too deep, so I'm going to patch that and go again. If I could turn back time to you. Thank you. Next is some metal blackener. I use Presto Metal Black, Sculpt Nouveau. Finally, just use a bit of fine steel wool. Clean it all up. It's a nice black patina. Penny Troll. A few months ago, my good friends at Dirty Shed Creations over in the UK sent me these bow ties for a project that I haven't done yet. But where can I use them? I might use them on my dirty old weld down here at the base of my clock down there. It's a bit of a scabby weld, so if I put that on the base there, it might look okay. I need to sharpen that drill.